everyone, welcome to Indian Curries and Pickles. This is the last episode of One Pot Wonder series. And we couldn't have moved on without making mutton biryani, Mughlai style. The traditional Mughal biryani is perfectly spiced meat chunks with kevada scented rice that emanate irresistible aroma and instantly make everyone hungry. So let's make this Mughlai style biryani in our last episode of One Pot Wonder series. These are soaked rice, this is hung curd, this is garlic and ginger paste, these are almonds, soaked almonds. You have to make paste out of all the three ingredients. This is sliced onion. These are the magical spices for the biryani. And remember, all the spices in the biryani makes the difference. So I'm going to use star anise, green elaichi or green cardamom, cinnamon, Jamaican pepper. This is jawitri, these are cloves, these are black peppers, these are garlic cloves. This is optional. If you're using ground garlic, you can use it, but I like the whole garlic better than the ground garlic. So I'm going to use both. And these are mutton cubes. You can take leg or shoulder, that is best for biryani. I'm going to marinate first. I'll add this garlic paste and ginger paste. Then I'm going to add some salt, little bit of turmeric, very little, and some red chilies and hung curd. And this mixture is going to be in the refrigerator for at least 2 hours. So now this is properly mixed. I'm going to keep it in the refrigerator for 2 hours. So now first we are going to add some mustard oil. So I make my biryani in mustard oil and desi ghee both. I never use refined oil. You can try, this will give a very nice aroma to your biryani. I'm going to add 2 spoons of desi ghee now for the flavor. I'm now going to burn my garlic first. Now I will add all the whole spices. This is Shahzira, this will give very nice flavor to the biryani. Now you can see garlic has turned golden brown. I'm going to add my onions now. Let's burn our onions also. It's going to give very nice caramelized flavor to the biryani. As you all might know that the difference between Mughlai biryani and Lakhnavi biryani is that in Mughlai biryani we cook everything together, and in Lakhnavi biryani we cook the rice and the meat separately and then we layer it. But today, as we are making Mughlai biryani, so I'm going to pressure cook my rice and meat together. I like Mughlai biryani better because the rice is soaked with flavors and juices of meat and everything. Though Lakhnavi biryani looks better, but the taste of Mughlai biryani is like heaven. At this stage, I'm going to add some nutmeg powder and some cardamom powder too. Nutmeg is also one spice which gives such a nice flavor to any dish you add, whether it's a sweet dish or your biryanis or your sabzis. I'm a big fan of nutmeg. Now you can see onions have started turning brown. We will take out few for the garnishing and rest we'll add to our mutton. So I'm going to take this much to garnish and rest onions we'll take mutton. Now we'll add marinated mutton. Now I'll add the leftover hung curd. I'm not going to add any tomatoes in this biryani. See the nice color. At this stage you can add some biryani masala. You can add any masala available at your place, but I use organic tattva. This is really good and I really highly recommend this one. Now I'm going to add some biryani masala. This will give very nice color to the biryani. Now all we have to do is we have to pressure cook the mutton for 15 to 20 minutes first, and then we'll add the rice to it. So let's keep the flame high, add some water and let it cook for 15 to 20 minutes. Now we are going to add some water to it and we'll pressure cook it for 15 minutes. Give it a good mix. Take care that your lid is properly done. Keep the flame high now. Mutton will take some 15 minutes. So now the mutton is half done. We are going to add the rice now. So there are enough juices. We are not going to add any more water to it. Now I'm going to add some essence. This is mithatha. I'm going to add some more red chilies or degi mirch for color. Now I'm going to add these soaked almonds. If you don't like whole almonds, you can also make paste out of it. I like it whole. Now we'll pressure cook it for another 5 minutes. So now you can shift the biryani in the platter you want to serve and give it a final run of dum. Now I will garnish it with a fried onion which we had taken out earlier. I'm going to add a little bit more biryani masala. Sprinkle some lemon juice. And keep some lemon veggies in the center for some nice citrus aroma. Put the chilies. And now we will dum it for another 2 to 3 minutes. Keep the lid tight and turn on the flame. So now after 2 to 3 minutes, it's finally done. So friends, with this sumptuous biryani, our One Pot Wonder series comes to an end. I hope you have thoroughly enjoyed it. If you have any feedback or suggestions, please do write it to us. So now we are going to start a short seasonal pickle series. So stay tuned. So friends, do follow us on our YouTube channel and don't forget to press the bell icon for future notifications. For the detailed recipe, press the title of the dish and you will get the detailed written recipe. Bye-bye.